Figure shows the muscle extensor digitorum longus rising from the anterior surface of fibula, passes down in front of the ankle joint and goes to the dorsum of foot to get inserted into the phalanges. The next one is the extensor hallucis longus, again arising from the front of fibula, passes under the extensor retinaculum and goes and gets inserted to the base of the distal phalanx of the big toe. The figure shows the origin of flexor hallucis longus from the fibula. It passes down, lies under the flexor retinaculum to get inserted into the base of the distal phalanx of the big toe. The large muscle is the soleus, arising from fibula and from tibia, and it forms part of the tendocalcaneus tendon, which gets inserted into the posterior surface of the calcanean bone. The muscle peroneus longus, arising from the lateral surface of fibula, passes on the lateral side of the ankle joint, passes through a groove in the cuboid bone and passes across the sole of the foot to get inserted into base of the first metatarsal and the base of the first metatarsal and adjoining part of the medial cuneiform bone.
Okay.
The figure shows peroneus longus arising from the fibula, passing behind the lateral malleolus, passes across the sole of the foot to get inserted into chiefly base of the first phalanx, base of the first metatarsal and adjoining part of the medial cuneiform bone. The other figure shows shorter peroneus brevis. It also passes on the lateral side of the ankle joint and gets inserted into the tuberosity of the base of the fifth metatarsal bone. Both these muscles are everters of the foot. The figure shows the insertion of biceps femoris muscle, one of the hamstrings. It gets inserted into the head of the fibula and its insertion is divided into two parts by the fibular collateral ligament. Next seen is the important common peroneal nerve related to the neck of fibula, where it gives a recurrent genicular nerve and ends by dividing into a deep peroneal nerve for the dorsiflexors of the foot and a superficial peroneal nerve for the everters of the foot. That is why in injury to common peroneal nerve, there is foot drop and loss of eversion leading to inversion of the foot.